Hello, I'm Chris Menard. Let me show you three ways to get numbers out of text strings. All three methods are pretty easy. One may or may not be available to you depending on what Office version or M365 version you have, but I'll tell you what versions each one works with as we go through here. Let's dive in. Method number one, one of my favorite commands in Excel is the flash fill. I need to pull the 50 units out of cell B2 and the 145 out of cell B3. So I'm going to type in 50. I'm going to type in 145. The minute I start typing in the 145, there is flash fill working. I look, I verify they're correct, and I press enter, and they're done. If by chance you didn't catch that, let me get rid of these. Type in at least two or three numbers to get the pattern going, and then in the empty cell below the last number, do Control E, and that is flash fill. If you're a mouse person, that is the same as going to data, flash fill right here. It even says Control E. That was method number one. Flash fill worked in Excel 2013 and up, which means Excel 2016, 19, 21, 24, and M365. Flash fill's been around a long time. The one issue is if flash fill is static. So if this 145 was incorrect and it's supposed to be 152, and I change it in cell B3, it doesn't reflect that in cell C3. So just be aware of that with flash fill. Method number two, and I'll tell it, I'll just keep these running across here. Method number two is to use text before and text after. So I'm trying to pull out that 50, and I'm going to use the text after function, cell B2, comma. What is my delimiter? It is the word sold and a space bar. And then I'm going to close the quotes. When I press enter, I'm not done, but it says 50 units in January. So let's edit that. And let's wrap that inside a text before, comma, what is my delimiter? After the 50 is a space bar and then the word units. That should take care of this. And it does pull that down. All the numbers are correct right there. So there's one way around it. One issue with text before and text after, and I love these functions. They're available if you have Excel 2021, Excel 2024, and Microsoft 365. Unfortunately, they're not going to work in your Excel 2019, and they will not work in Excel 2016. I highlighted all six of these numbers, and notice in my status bar in the bottom right, I have a count. Well, count's no good, so I'm going to back to cell D2, and let's wrap this in the value function. Now the 50 went from left align to right align, autofill it down. Take a peek in the bottom right of my status bar. I see sum, average. So now these are truly numbers. There is that function right there. 2021, 2024, and M365, text before and text after. Finally, if you have an M365 license, a new function is RegExtract. Here's my text. Comma, what is the pattern I'm looking for? I'm looking for decimals, that is the letter D, and I'm looking, if I just do a D, if I don't do the plus sign, I'm only going to get the number 5, and then in the next cell down, the 152, I'd only get the number 1. So you need to put a D and a plus sign, and that should take care of this. Perfect, just to prove you need the plus sign, if I remove the D, if I remove the plus sign and just leave the D, I'm going to end up with that. So let me go back here. Perfect. And again, you can put this in the value function right here. There you go. One advantage that the RegExtract function has over in E2 is if by chance, notice cell B3 says sold in February 152 units. My flash fill is wrong because of the numbers being changed. My text before and text after doesn't work, but still the regex would. So I'm just telling you your different options here. And again, regex is only for M365 users, but it is a great function right here. I did it pulling out numbers, but you know, I will make a follow-up video using RegExtract pulling out text. Thank you for your time. Have a wonderful day. My training classes are available online for Copilot, Teams, OneNote, and Excel. Thank you.